Burton here, final part of the three-part how to install an RFID ignition. So, SevCon, I've had a video before about an always-on 12-volt voltage supply, which doesn't exist. But the SevCon, as we remember, pins 3 and 4 here have a negative-positive always-on source, and if you bridge these two, it turns on the SevCon. So, what you need to do is you need to take your boot way back here, and you need to peel it back just enough to get some room in. There's going to be a zip tie up at the top, and you're going to have two groups of black wires essentially coming out. You want to break the zip tie on the group that's got the bundle of four wires, and then strip down the orange electrical tape here about 5 inches, roughly, and then zip this back up to the top, put your boot back on, and then put your two posy taps in here, or whatever taps you're going to use. Now I'm going to pause the video here, do that, and show you what it looks like. Once you get the boot reinstalled, you want to re-expose the wires. You should have went down 5 inches, and if you did that, you'll have about 3 inches of room where the electrical tape isn't. So you want to find the orange black stripe wire, and that's going to be your ground. The orange blue stripe wire is your positive. So right now the circuit is hooked up via these posy taps, and it's just running through a series of connectors. There's a fuse down here, and then that runs to the power supply up here. You see the power supply's off. This switch, my old ignition switch, is in line right now. So if I turn this on, it feeds the power supply. So now the power supply is on, but you'll see that I haven't hooked it up to the circuit yet. So let's hook it up here. So now it's hooked up, but the switch is off. The whole box is off. So let's turn the box on. We'll grab the RFID tag here, and then currently the right down here is where the antenna is. So I'm going to move that so it's in frame a little better here. There we go. We have the LED that indicates when the RFID is presented. So if we present the tag, you'll see now that the bike is starting up. And it's up. And say we need an emergency and we need to stop, we hit the switch, the bike's off. Turn the switch back on. Bike is still off. Take the RFID tag, re-present it, bike turns on. If you present multiple times, it doesn't do anything because it's always going to keep those relays pressed. So some concerns that you might have. If you soldered stuff in here, you might have a concern of vibration. And if it vibrates a lot, it might end up being that stuff comes loose. So what I've done in case stuff comes loose is I've standardized all my connections to have this, I call them motorcycle connections. So Yamaha made these popular, if I recall. So all my connections have these, and if I have to on the road, I can cut electrical tape and wire up a hard switch if I have to. That's obviously bad in some ways, because someone could also wire your bike up the wrong way. So you have to hide things appropriately, make it hard to get to so that they have to spend more time doing it, but otherwise it works. You can see it's on, hit the switch, it's off. Very cool. If you have any questions, feel free to ask.